Good morning, everyone. She Fitness Studio, we have a standing bar workout today. We're going to be focusing specifically on the core and the upper body. You can have ankle weights, you can have light weights for the total workout. You don't have to have weights at all. You need a sturdy chair, again, to intensify the moves. If you don't have a chair, you don't have a bar, a counter, a bench. We also have some benches back there that we're using. You can do it on the floor. Again, we will have some modifications. We do have special guests in the house today, and it's Leo, Leah, and Miyagi. There are mascots as well inside. So here we go. We're gonna go ahead and begin with second position. Abdominals are nice and tight, shoulders back. We're gonna go ahead and raise the arms all the way up, and we're gonna exhale down. We're not gonna go too far just yet. We'll do two more. And today's workout's gonna be specifically more like progression. We're gonna keep the arms up, nice and long. Legs, we're gonna stretch to the side. Should you feel that you want to go ahead and do the workouts again, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can do the workout twice or three times around, one more time. In the middle, we're gonna go ahead and exhale. We're gonna roll the shoulders back for four, three, two, one more. And we're just gonna hold those shoulders all the way back, slightly bend the knees, and all we're gonna do is we're gonna shift our waist to the side. We're gonna go left and right, your right, our left. We're gonna go for singles right now. We'll do about 20 of these. Exhale, and you're moving through the waist, not through the shoulder. Go as deep to the side as you can. Exhale, don't hold your breath. Now, if you want, you can go down a little bit lower. Exhale. Don't forget about the shoulders being pulled back and down. Nice deep breathing. This is a great core workout, specifically focusing on your oblique, external, internal. Exhale. The slower the better. From here, we're gonna go into a single, single, double, double. It's one, one, double, double, single, single, double, double, single, single, double, double. Rain or shine, we're here. It's pouring out there, but it's just so beautiful. And we don't wanna miss any workouts. There are no excuses. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. So we're gonna start picking up the tempo just a little bit. Double, here we go. One, one, two. One, one, two. It's like you're pushing the door away. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. One, one, two. One, one, two. One, one, two. One, one. You gotta warm up the core. Single, single, double. Single, single, double. Just a couple more. One, one, two. One, one, two. One, one, two. We're gonna go for two more. One, one, two. One, one, two. One more time. Single, single. Double, single, single, double. Good. We're gonna take the arms down, roll the shoulder back. We're gonna go ahead and do a nice plie down, and we're gonna go in four counts. It goes like this. One, two, three, four. Come back in the middle. Rotate center. Two, three. Go back side again. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Hold in the middle. One. Now you don't have to go too far. Center. One, two, three. Dynamic. One. Hold. We're gonna go 10 to one side, 10 to the opposite. Hold. Hold. One, two, three. Four, one, two, like fingers, Exhale. Breathe. We have about four more. You're going to notice that your legs are also working. Anytime you need to take a break, stretch out your legs. Two more. We have light fingers. Last one. Now we're going to begin with the leading side opposite, our right, your left. It's going to go one, two, three, four, one, two, three, one. A great way to start your day. Two, three, four. We have five more. And two. And one. Nice. We're going to go ahead. Roll the shoulder back. We're going to dig into one side. Put your body weight on the heel. Arms are like a windmill. And you're going to take that side. We're going to go here. Look all the way to the back. And rotate up. Point to each side, begin, rotate, one, you're twisting through the waist, not the shoulder, you can see a little bit of that inner thigh, you're tapping to the front, one more, now we're going to do the same thing except we're going to tap front and back. And back. Two. Four. Five more. Exhale. One. Two. Three. Hold it. Slowly come back to the opposite side. Readjust. Abs are nice and tight. Toes facing forward. Roll the shoulder back. Side lunge. Again, putting your body weight on your heel as well as the core, not the knee. And we're going to begin. Rotate front and front. Front like a windmill. Two. Three. Tap into the front. We have five. One more. Same thing. We tap front and back. Front and back. So you're just changing the angle of that windmill. Three. Four. Five. Exhale. Eight. Nine. And ten. Nice. Come into the center. All right. Abs are nice and tight, rotate the shoulders back. We're gonna begin with alternating sides. It looks like this. It's what we call a side crunch here, a twist, and a kick, alternating. Our left, your right, we'll begin with a twist. Here we go. It's one, it's two, here, 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 out. Twist, side, kick, twist, side, chop, twist, side, kick. We're going for 20. Now we're not repeating these exercises. Really focus, holding your abs in without holding your breath. Twist, side, chop kick. Twist, side, chop kick. Twist. So we are at the mercy of Natalie because I usually, when she's here, I don't count. Twist, knee, four. Of course, if you have ankle weights, it will intensify the move. Twist, side, twist. Nice. All right. Please make sure you have a chair, a bench, something sturdy to work on. We're going to lift up the leg. Standing leg will be nice and soft, not too hard, not too low for this one. And we're going to do the same exact cross knee twist. We have 20. Here we go. Chest is up. Abs are nice and tight. Pull the shoulders back and down. Give me 20 twists. Please begin. Here, now, you can have your foot flat, or you can releve. It's up to you. These are standing bar exercises. We're gonna take that leg a little further out. We're gonna plie down, take the arms out. Please make sure that your chair does not go flying around. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go side, 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 and twist. Come right back in the middle. So it's side, 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 hold, twist it. Notice that my back arm stays stable here, twist. So it's one, two, three, twist. One, two, three, hold. One, two, three, hold. One, two, three, hold. The lower you go, the more work you're gonna get. The higher you go, it's not that you're not working, you're just not working legs. But you'll notice you are working waist. Down, 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 up. So connect mind muscle connection. What are you working? Side, 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 middle, twist. Side, 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 middle. Again, you can do a releve. Side, 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 middle. Side, two, three, hold. One pound, if you are holding any, 1-2 pounds is more than enough. One, two, three, four, five, seven. two, three, four, five, seven. One, two, three, four, five, seven. One. Why this exercise works is because you're working different direction of the same muscle. One more. Perfect. We're gonna come back and bring that leg a little closer to the chair. And instead of doing a twist, we're gonna do the same thing, except we're gonna lift with that hip and that waist. Looks like this. One. Back to that foot. Again, you can relevate or you can place it flat. Your call. Ready and go. One. Now, if you don't have a chair, you could be right here. Standing leg, nice and soft. We have 20 of these. Exhale. We're gonna turn it. Abs are nice and tight, shoulder back. Again, releve or flat. We're gonna do a 20 abdominal crunch. Standing leg will be slightly bent. Please begin. Here. Really crunch it up. We can do the same thing with the knee bent, or we can extend the leg. You can raise your arms up so it can look like this. You can do it this way, or you can do it this way. One. So you don't have to take your arms up. You don't have to lift up the leg. You don't have to straighten the leg, but really crunch, whether it's bent or straight. This takes away from using your hip flexor. We're gonna turn one more time to you guys. We'll turn to the front and we're gonna do the same thing, except this time we're gonna sweep that leg across. Follow that gaze. Now you're gonna notice, I'm lifting my leg. Natalie has chosen to keep her leg on the chair. Please, variations, follow what's comfortable. Just challenge yourself just a little bit more. Dynamic twist. Nice and powerful. One more thing, take the arms out, and once again, you can follow Nat keeping the leg on the chair, or you can just lift it up here, here, or you can actually just keep it up here. 20 of these. Two. You can try a couple, place it back on the chair, and then go back and not tap the chair. Works a little bit more balance. Exhale, nice light fingers. Good, that's it. Other side, here we go. We're gonna slowly move the chair to the opposite side. Once again, our knees are bent, abs are nice and tight. You're gonna feel those hips working. We'll begin here. Your foot could be a releve, or it could be flat. Standing leg nice and bent, arms nice and light. And here we go, twist, 20. Now you're gonna dig a little bit quicker. Please let us know if you are doing these workouts. And if you have any comments, don't forget to go ahead and send us a message. If you want different workouts, you can run away, but make sure that you're placing your toes, all of them, on the chair. Take that leg a little further out, down to plie, roll shoulders back, open up the arms, and we're gonna do the same exact thing if you recall. We're gonna go side, 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 come back, twist, middle. One, two, three, four, middle, five, stretch. One, two, three, four, five, twist, open, side, side reach, middle, twist, hold, hold when you twist to really feel that muscle working, middle, tap, open, one, two, three, four, middle, open, side. Again, if you choose to stand, you can. You're still gonna work that waist. Middle, twist, open. Slightly bend. If you want a full plie, you can. Reach, 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 reach. Middle, tap, open. Side, 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 side. Middle. Exhale. When you tap those hands, really push the opposite hand, a lot more reinforcement on that waist. It's side, 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 middle. One, two, three, four, just like a windmill, tap, open, side, 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 hold, tap, open, one, two, three, four, middle, open, one, two, three. Focus on also keeping your tailbone heavy. You don't want to be pulling back. One, exhale, open chest. Last one. Hold, perfect. We're gonna go back and do a releve if you want, or you can keep it flat. We're gonna go ahead and do that side crunch, 20 of these, here we go. Focus on that waist lifting. Standing legs nicely bent, not too low, but you'll notice that the fingers are very light. If you're tapping your toes, be aware that your toes should be relaxed. You're pushing your force all the way to the front foot. We're not favoring one toe over another. Good. We're gonna come back and stay in the middle. Abs are nice and tight, shoulder back. We're gonna lift up, and from here, again, you can relevate or you can keep your foot down. As long as you're not using the chair, we begin with 20 crunches, go. In. Your stand leg should be bent. Pull through the gut, right here. Exhale, working. Inhale when you're not. We can do the same thing, but we're going to raise our arms up and we can keep them like bent, or we can expand. Here we go. Lift. Up. Up. I want to make sure that we're not kicking, we're extending through the core. If you want to really work it, straighten up that leg. Drop the heel. Each move should be 2 breaths. Your foot can be on the chair, on the floor. You don't have to lift, just make it dynamic. Your weight should be distributed in the center. We're not leaning to the side. Push through that gut, through that core. Nice. We're gonna go ahead and lift the arms up. You can keep them on your waist or you can extend those arms out as long as they're pulled back and down. We can keep the foot on the chair or we can just add a little bit more balance. So we're just gonna tap here or don't touch the chair, 20 of these. Now, the higher you go with the shoulder, the more waist you're gonna work. We have 10 more. Again, you can drop your arm if you want to, but I know that my shoulders are back and down. Nice, drop it down. From here, we're gonna roll the shoulders back. We're gonna come into a sitting position. Like so, you're gonna take your arms down, and we call this somewhat of a pendulum because you're just gonna be moving side to side, except it's happening through the core, not through the shoulder. Shoulder back, abs in, tuck your hip, there's no arch, you wanna make sure that you're tucking, come down. Hands together, and all you're gonna do is you're gonna twist side, side. Follow your hand. If you really want to work hard, take your hands and push them in like they're glued. Can we get 10 in here? Remember, push the bottom hand into the top. Nice and light on your feet. Working the upper part of your waist towards the back. Now, we're gonna hold, hold, hold. Your top arm is gonna push down on that bottom and we're just gonna pulse for 20. One. Your knees should stay slightly bent. Do not cave your knees in. Exhale. Hold, come back to the center, other side, push all the way up, bottom hand, on top of the other, and we're just gonna pulse, two. Toes facing forward, exhale. Hold. Come back to the middle, hands above your knees, arch the back, look up and round. Look up, round all the way back. We're gonna go ahead and do one more thing. If you can do this on the chair or you can do it on the floor, it's your call. We're gonna go into a plank. A plank is working the whole entire core. If your legs are squeezed together, it means that you're also working your glutes. We're gonna be here. We're gonna do 10 alternating where your knee is gonna meet the elbow, it's gonna twist, it's gonna come back, and tap back. Again, modifications, please follow Natalie if you need to. Modification will be in, my foot stays on the floor, in, and back. Here we go. Last set of core exercises, and we're gonna get some off the body. Chest is up, abs are nice and tight. Please begin our front leg, your front leg as well. We're gonna go in, one, rotate, in. Notice that when I extend my leg, point the toe, really work through those glutes. Tap, corner, corner, back. The slower, the better. You can look down with your eyes, not with your neck. In, corner, in. You're moving the knee through the waist. Two more. We're gonna pick it in. We're gonna tap elbow, elbow together. Here we go. 10. Now you really wanna work that waist. You can swing the leg, isolating your core. Hold it out, take that leg out, holding 10, 9, 8, 6, 4, point it out, hold through that waist for 10, 9, 8, 7, 4, 3, 2, bring that leg down. Walk it in, round the back. Exhale, look up, nice flat back, extending to the opposite side, here we go. Abs are nice and tight, shoulder back, we'll begin. Same side tap, and then we corner, here we go. It's one, two, tap, point. Give yourself enough time to point and really work through those glutes. With a plank, you're working total body. Bicep, tricep, shoulder, abs, back, hip, glutes. Opposite leg is working calf, mind-muscle connection. Breathe it out. The more you're taking oxygen, the more energy you're gonna get. From here, we're gonna take it in, and here we go. We're gonna go in and out. We swing it out. You're swinging through the waist, not the hip. Hold it out, extending that leg. Abs are tight, chest is up, holding 10. Really squeeze your glutes. 5, 4, 3, 2, and slowly bring it in. Nice, roll the shoulder back. We're gonna keep our heads up when we come down to pick up our weights. We're gonna begin three consecutive exercises, set of 20. We're gonna start with ballet arms. Roll the shoulder back. Pick up your weights. Ballet arms are where the arms are somewhat of a semicircle, so I'm gonna show you what it looks like, just like this, except we're gonna be up here. Fingertips can be touching or they don't have to be. From here, we're gonna alternate our left, your right. We're gonna go up and down. Here we go. Up and up. Up and up. So we're gonna go three sets, 20 reps, three different types of exercises. Again, if you don't feel it tomorrow or today, I will suggest pick up a heavier weight, just 1 pound more, not more than that. If you're using two today, use three tomorrow. Or you can increase, instead of doing three sets, you can do four sets of 20. Keep keeping your arms circle. Very important that those arms stay circle. These are compound moves, which means that a couple of muscles working at the same time. Good. We're going to go in now and we're going to roll the shoulders back. We're going to take the arms up. And from here, you can rotate the feet back. It's a little bit easier on the shoulders. And all you're going to do is you're going to come down. And I want to see you guys push back, down, and come right back up and open. Now, when I come back, I'm squeezing my shoulders. Squeeze. So you want to feel those shoulder blades connecting. Squeeze. Shoulder back and down. Body weight on the heel. We have 10 more. At your own pace, your own tempo, but you need to do these exercises slow. In Pilates and bar classes, yoga, the exercises should be slow. We don't use momentum. Controlled moves. Nice deep breathing. I'll say again, ladies and gentlemen, you're under the mercy of Natalie because she's the counter. And I just don't count. Now, we're gonna take those arms back and notice they're in somewhat of a V position. They're right where my hips are from here. And all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go 20 of these. So we're gonna open up like a V. Don't drop them below your hips. Chest is up. I'll see a lot of us doing this sometimes, pulling that neck back. Now here you can be in first position if you want, or you can stand parallel. We're gonna go back once again. We're gonna start with our right, your left. Ballet arms. Notice that my arms stay center in front of me. I don't drop them to my legs. Reach as far back as you can without putting any pressure on your shoulder. Again, you want to be in first position. Barre inspired, go right ahead. Repetition is what makes us really stronger. It gives the muscles leaner, longer look, a sleek arm look. When you're dropping down, drop down with control. Nice deep breathing. Your weights should be nice and light. Every once in a while, open up your fingers to make sure that you're not holding too tight. Anyone could do these exercises with or without weights. From here, we're gonna go back and open up the feet parallel. And we're gonna open up into a bicep, and then we're just gonna lean down and extend. Up and down. Focusing on the shoulders. When I lift up, you want to really stress the shoulder muscle, open up the chest, squeeze into the shoulder blades, make contact with those shoulder blades, stretch the chest, squeeze shoulder. I'm sitting back, I make sure I focus on my abs, stay engaged, so my back is well supported. So it's raining today in Miami. We're gonna suggest you come back and do this workout again. All right, we're gonna take the palms back up again. V position, we're gonna lift up, hip level. Open, come back. Open, come back. Now I wanna make sure that you're holding one, two, and then slowly bring it down. That way you're working a lot more tricep. You can hold in position one, feet. Nice straight spine. You don't wanna be looking down with your neck. We have one more circuit, and if you notice yourself breathing heavy, that's a good thing, that's cardio. Open up the chest, squeeze the shoulders together. And from here, we have one more set. We're gonna go back into, again, ballet arms. We're gonna lift, alternating. One, one, two, two. Light hands, control the downbeat. Notice that I don't let my arms drop all the way. Your arms should be somewhat in a semicircle. Elbows are nice and soft. Working the shoulder, front part of your shoulder, we call the deltoid. In case. We're not swinging, we control the weights, or just lifting up the arms should be controlled. From here, we're gonna take those arms up again one more time. From here, really open up the chest and squeeze. Have contact with the shoulder blades. You can rotate your heels back into parallel. And again, we're gonna go down, squeeze. Like you're trying to put your shoulder blades in your back pocket. Squeeze. Having strong shoulders will give us a longer, taller look. Rounded shoulders makes us look a little shorter. Breathe it out. Anybody interested in getting cats, please make sure you adopt, don't buy. I needed to say that now. One more, and from here we're gonna take those arms out. Once again, if you take them out a little further, it's a little bit more intense. We're gonna go out, hold one, two, slowly bring it back down to those hips. One, two, back down. One, two, back down. The head of your weight is facing your thigh. This is it, you're almost done. Stay with it. Whatever you do, make sure you get up and move. The weather doesn't permit us, but we do what we can. I have a theory, every 15 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes, if you're sitting on your computer or watching TV, you should get up. And if you have stairs, make it a point. I always do that, to lead things upstairs, to go up and down. As you recall, one of our tips was for every 5 steps, you're burning 1 calorie. Not a bad thing. again here, my abs are tight, my glutes are tight. We're gonna hold. We're gonna face those palms up, keeping your arms back. Chest is up, your palms are up. We're gonna take those arms into a T position and hold. Once again, you're pushing your chest out, you're pressing the shoulder blades together, and we're gonna hold for 10. Now, if you feel that your neck is being jeopardized, please lose the weight. Here's 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and slowly release those arms down. We're gonna roll the shoulders back. We're gonna finally come to an end. We're gonna stretch, keep the weights in your hands. We're gonna take the arms all the way up. Make sure that you don't arch the back, tuck your hips in. Come down to one side as you lift up that one arm all the way up straight, opposite arm comes down, hold the stretch. Breathe it out, keeping that arm next to you. You're gonna go ahead and make sure that your hips go back, not to the side, as the arm goes to the opposite leg. Pull that arm back up again, and we're gonna take both arms up. We're gonna take the palms in, cup to the side. Breathe it out. Center, opposite side. Notice that your hips should be nice and isolated. They're not moving. Go back to the center. Dropping that opposite arm down. Extend that arm as far up as you can and come all the way down and hold. As I drop my top arm to my opposite foot, I want to make sure my hips go back, not to the side. Keep that arm right next to you as you come down and push your hips back. Slowly lift your arms all the way back up again. Arms out, shoulder back. Coming into first position. Roll shoulders for 3 counts, 2 and 1. All the way up. Bringing your hands closer to your heart. Slowly come down. Round back, drop those arms all the way up, and let's do that one again. Inhale. Exhale down, hand heart. All the way down. And it is Friday, guys. We hope you have been with us all week. We hope you enjoyed the workout. Exhale down. Roll the shoulder back. Once again, She Fitness Studio and the She Fitness crew thanks you. We hope you subscribe and stay tuned for the next workout. Thank